And also heavy on hearts and minds tonight across the country and here at home is what happened to 16-year-old Nex Benedict. Why did they die a day after a fight in their high school bathroom in Oklahoma? A preliminary autopsy said it wasn't trauma. So what was it? Any death is tragic, but this one is causing panic for LGBTQ youth because Nex was one of them. A non-binary kid who told their parents and police after the fight that they were bullied because of who they were. That was Lieutenant Governor Peggy Flanagan at our Capitol this morning for Out Front Lobby Day, taking a moment of remembrance for Nex Benedict. In Minnesota, 16% of high school juniors said in last year's student survey that they are bullied for their gender expression at least once a month while they're at school. So what happened to Nex deeply matters to them. Here's Kent Erdahl.
Smile. Out Front Minnesota was out front at the state capitol this morning to advocate for legislation that promotes the human rights of LGBTQ Minnesotans. And for one group of teens, that platform begins with one critical step.
Protecting us.
Yeah.
I was a target of a lot of bullying, especially in my early years.
16-year-old Ace isn't alone.
I was having a tough year, so I ended up going into a mental health program.
16-year-old Archer and their classmate Lola say they are grateful, along with Ace and 15-year-old Alex, to have found Northwest Passage Charter School in Coon Rapids.
At Northwest Passage, we have all the bathrooms are gender neutral. Everything's on one level, so there's no elevators or stairs needed. And all the staff are really helpful.
All of our youth, all of our young people deserve to be affirmed and supported and celebrated and loved.
While signs of that love surrounded the students on Tuesday, their hearts were heavy with lingering questions about the tragedy in Oklahoma.
I think it's important that we remember Nex Benedict, that we continue to speak their name, and that they know how much we love them.
I've tried my best to avoid it because it brings up bad memories of my past because I nearly ended up like that.
It could have been me, you know, and that's scary. And it could have been one of my friends, and that happens more than it should.
I did a project last session of trans deaths in the Midwest, and there really wasn't that much coverage.
And even in a state that prioritized and passed the trans refuge bill last session, the students say the reality for many Minnesota kids varies.
I've had many friends who have had problems with the school system, and I just want what's right for them.
Responsibility should be taken either with the school, the student itself, or the parent.
We were all taught to stand up to bullies, and that is what this mama bear, and that is what you all are doing here today.
It matters so our voice doesn't get over, so our voice doesn't get suppressed. A lot of kids, especially if they have become targets of bullying at a young age, we stop trying. We stop speaking up for ourselves. We become complacent. Don't be complacent with how people treat you.
Yeah. When it happens so much, you get used to the behavior and you don't even realize that it's wrong.
Which is exactly why this group wanted to stand up today and in doing so, take a step to sending one more message.
We are real. We are here. We're not broken. We can't be fixed. There's nothing wrong with us. And we are going to continue to exist as we always have.
Don't be complacent with how people treat you. Thank you for those messages tonight. We'll be right back.